sensations in this host are different from the others. I'm experiencing physical pain. Why should any species have to endure this weakness?
Because the desire to overcome it will spur them to move beyond the limitations of the physical world.
You can't be awake.
Our ancestors were physical beings.
Well, what worked for us might not work for everyone. Humans have different qualities.
Nothing I haven't seen before.
We're being observed.
Ah, Captain DePaul. I was just coming to see you.
Are you responsible for what happened to my patients?
We had nothing to do with it.
We come here only to study how physical species react to the unknown.
Is there anything you can do to help my patients?
We're here to observe. We can't interfere. You were inhabited a few hours ago, an intriguing experience.
I have no recollection of that.
Memories are simple to adjust.
You're going to adjust mine again, So I won't remember a word of this encounter. If you have that ability, you must be able to help my patients.
We could.
But we won't.
With a simple story driven by a classic literary technique, foreshadowing, Star Trek Enterprise's Observer Effect celebrates some of humanity's most admirable qualities, compassion and empathy, making it a Trek for all time. In research, the observer effect is most commonly thought of as the effect an observer can have on its observed subjects. For example, if a scientist wishes to observe an animal in its natural habitat, it must remain hidden from the animal so as not to change the animal's behavior. Animals change their behavior when watched. And so do humans. But a less common way to interpret the observer effect is the distortion of what is observed by the observer's biased perception. In the case of this episode of Star Trek, the veteran Organian, who is often inhabiting Malcolm's body, perceives and evaluates Archer and his crew through the lens of hundreds of years of expectations and experiences on observation missions. His people choose to learn about other races through observation. Now, the Organian inhabiting Travis seems to be on his first mission, perceiving the events with fresh eyes, without bias.
We're leaving now, Captain. You won't remember a thing about our presence.
And in 3 hours, you'll die as well.
No. We have the power to save them all.
Are you defying me?
I'm defying the entire protocol. What Archer has done today, his act of compassion, you've never witnessed that before.
In time, we'll study other humans.
And these two perspectives become the audience's eyes and ears, offering commentary on events, and more importantly, foreshadowing events to come, namely, death.
How do you think they'll react to what's on this planet?
That's what we're here to find out. For some of the species that have come here, I've seen the whole crew die. For others, only a few.
But somebody always dies.
Always.
The story is simple, but its execution is masterful. There's little special effects, little action, no new sets or guest stars. In many ways, this is a low-budget episode. But the stakes are high, and the performances really sell the desperate situation. And as Hoshi and Trip spend time together, talking, we finally get some real good character development from Hoshi. The series finally acknowledges that she's brilliant, and we get a glimpse into her roguishness that we've never seen from her before. And in a world marred by the COVID-19 virus, the quarantine and virus elements of the story amplifies the drama much more than when the episode originally aired in 2005. Anyway, Oddly enough, this episode shines a light on the dangers of becoming a jaded professional, arguing for the necessity of fresh eyes in any profession. The more experienced Organian simply could not see that humanity was approaching the virus situation differently than any other species he had originally seen. Now this is the observer effect of the episode's title. It's the distortion of the observer's perception by his own biases. The novice Organian, however, could observe and interpret the choices and actions of Archer and his crew without the bias of hundreds of years of observations. This is a critical and valuable lesson to incorporate into our own decision-making at work, especially as an established voice within your profession. But that idea is not the core of this episode. No, this episode's theme is simple. Two of humanity's most defining qualities are compassion and empathy. It is our ability to feel the plight of others, becoming intimately entangled in their perspective, their feelings, and their fate. It is our ability to almost become the other that makes life worth living. And that's what Archer suggests when he pleads with the Organians to save his crew.
You knew about the virus that killed two members of my crew and you didn't warn us?
I wanted to. Tell me what happens to Trip and Hoshi when you're finished with their bodies.
We have to leave them as they are.
I understand why you won't get involved with a species' natural development. I faced that decision myself. It isn't an easy one to make.
Then we agree.
No, we don't. Our encounter with the virus was an accident, one that you could have prevented.
Then how would we ever learn about you?
Ask us. Talk to us, just like you're doing now.
Talking is a limited form of communication for us. We're much more advanced than humans.
Not from where I'm standing. You've evolved into beings with abilities I can't comprehend, but you've paid a hell of a price. You've lost compassion and empathy, things that give life meaning. If that's what it takes to be advanced, I don't want any part of it.
What Archer has done today, his act of compassion, you've never witnessed that before.
In time, we'll study other humans.
There's another way. Experience compassion for yourself. You want to know what it means to be human. Need to do more than observe.
Star Trek offers a rich collection of meaningful speeches on a variety of issues, from ethical to more categorical, describing some category of the human condition, and Archer's speech seems to simply intertwine both topics, using the discussion about humanity to compel the Organians to act ethically, accepting responsibility for the crew's predicament, and then intervene. There's no complexity here. There's not a lot of layers to Archer's argument or the issues of non-interference. No, this episode aims clearly to affirm the good that humanity is capable of. Our ability to have compassion and empathy for others. And this, of course, is why this is a Trek for all time.